This video covers the use of patterns for horizontal discovery. Linked time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. Service mapping and discovery use patterns in their discovery process. A pattern is a sequence of operations whose purpose is to establish attributes of a CI. In this video, we'll focus on the use of patterns in horizontal discovery, where they are used to discover a main CI type along with CIs related to it. The CI we'll be discovering in this demo is a Linux server. The platform comes with a wide range of pre-configured CI types that covers the most commonly used applications. If your organization uses a less known or proprietary application that doesn't have a corresponding CI type, you must create one. Navigate to the CI Class Manager and search for the server. As we can see, a CI type for Linux server already exists. For this demo, we'll create a new one. Click on Extend on the server table. Give the table a label and name. Names for CI types should always start with CMDB_CI. If necessary, you can add more columns for the table. For the purpose of this video, we're going to use the columns automatically inherited from the parent server table. Identifiers are used to determine if a discovered CI already exists in the CMDB or is a brand new one. Here, the identifier being used is the hardware rule, and it's inherited from its parent table, the server. For example, this rule has an identifier entry with the criterion attribute serial number and serial number type. Its search on table field is set to serial number. When the hardware rule is applied, the serial number table is searched for a match with the values returned from the device. If no match is found, then the identification search continues to the next rule entry. If all the rules are checked without finding a match, a new CI record is created in the database. In order to launch a discovery for a CI, we need to define a classification. We'll now create a Unix classification for the Linux server. Give the classifier a name and define the table that will be associated with the classified CI. Each type of discovery classify probe returns a unique set of parameters that contains classification information. Define the classification criteria by entering the name, setting the operator to equals, and entering Linux in the value field. If the classification criteria are true, then the probes on the Triggers Probes tab are launched. After creating our pattern, we must return to this classifier and add a probe that will launch this new pattern. Now that we have a table and classifier for a CI type, we'll create the pattern to discover it. Navigate to Discovery Patterns table and click New. Give the pattern a name and select Infrastructure as the pattern type. To create a pattern to discover an application such as Apache or Tomcat, choose Application as the pattern type. Choose the CI we defined earlier as the CI type. Let's take a look at the new pattern we created. Under the Pattern tab, we can view the NDL, a markup language describing the pattern's metadata and steps. We'll discuss steps later. These are tables that are related to our main CI type, the Linux server. Related CIs are discovered together with the main CI using the pattern. For example, each Linux server has a hard drive, which is a CI of its own. We're going to add the hard drive CI to the list of related CIs, which will allow us to discover it along with the Linux server. Click New and choose CI type disk. Further editing of the pattern, including creating steps, is done in the Pattern Designer application. Click Edit for Discovery to open this application. There is one default identification section for an infrastructure pattern called Discovery. It's important to note that when using patterns for discovery, both the identification and exploration phase happen together when the pattern runs, as opposed to previously when these phases were separate and had different probes and sensors. To discover a CI, a pattern performs a set of operations, also known as steps. A list of steps and their order can be seen in the pane on the left, called the Steps tree. In the middle pane, we see the step that is selected in the Steps tree pane. On the right, you see the tables and variables discovered and created during the debug session. The debug session allows you to run operations against a device in real time. To connect to the device and start a debug session, click Debug and enter the host's IP address. The related tables we added previously can now be seen. Here's the hard drive CI table. To add a new step, right-click on a step and choose either Add Step Before or Add Step After. Next, choose an operation such as Parse Command Output. For our demonstration, we'll get and define the details of the Linux's CPU. Here we'll enter a command that displays the CPU info file. To run the command on the device and display the result, click Run Command. Choose the parsing strategy for the result. In the Variables table, add a variable called CPU data to hold the data received. We'll now give an appropriate name for this step. Steps can be tested by clicking on the Test button. Here we can see the result. When moving to the next step, the debugger also runs and inserts the result into the list of temporary variables on the side. After adding some more steps, we now have a complete pattern we can use for discovery. Here we can see the steps that have been added to parse the CPU info and populate the CMDB, CI, Linux, Demo table. Looking at the Linux server table, we can see that the information about the CPU has been correctly added. Now that we've created our pattern, let's go back to the classification and use our pattern to discover the Linux server. Navigate back to the Linux Demo classification. Under the Triggers Probe tab, click Edit. Add the Horizontal Pattern Probe and click Save. Make sure that the phase is Identification. As you can see, the pattern associated with the probe is empty. Let's choose our Linux Demo as the pattern. We'll now run a quick discovery on a Linux device using the pattern we created. Enter the device's IP address. The discovery is complete. Here we can see that the device was discovered. If you take a look at the discovery log, you can see that the Linux Demo pattern was used. To view more details about the running of the pattern, check out Pattern Discovery Log. This can be accessed both through the Navigator and through the Discovery Log. In the Discovery node, we can view all steps that were run. A step that ran successfully is marked green. A failed step appears red. Click a step to see its details. The processing done to the payload on the instance side can be viewed under Payload Processing. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.